PCI Express is the backbone of modern computing systems, connecting critical components in everything from personal computers to massive data centers. To understand PCI Express, we must look at its predecessor, the Peripheral Component Interconnect Standard, or PCI. Introduced in 1992, with the final iteration released in 2004. PCI used a parallel interface where multiple devices shared the same electrical bus. This shared bus became a bottleneck as computing needs grew. Clock skew issues also limited the maximum frequency, constraining data rates. PCI Express, or PCIe for short, was created in 2003 as PCI Express 1.0. It brought a fundamental change, a switch from parallel to serial communication. PCIe uses point-to-point connections, with each device having a dedicated connection. This architecture allows for much higher data rates and solves many PCI limitations. PCIe's architecture is built on three key concepts: lanes, links, and data rates. A PCIe lane is the basic unit for data transfer. It consists of four wires, two for sending data and two for receiving. These form two differential pairs, one for each direction, which helps reduce electromagnetic interference and allows for higher signaling rates as well as full duplex data transfer. The link is the full connection between two PCIe devices comprising of one or more lanes. Links are described as by 1, by 2, by 4, by 8, by 16, or by 32, indicating the number of lanes. This is reflected in the physical sizes of PCIe slots on motherboards. PCIe devices can negotiate length width. For example, a by 16 capable device can operate in a by 8 slot by using fewer lanes. This negotiation happens automatically during initialization, providing flexibility in system design. The data rate of a PCIe connection depends on two factors: the generation and the number of lanes. This scalability allows PCIe to serve in applications from low-power embedded systems to high-performance computing. Since its introduction, PCIe has evolved through six generations, soon to be seven, each bringing significant improvements. Gen 1, introduced in 2003, established the basic architecture and offered 2.5 gigatransfer per second per lane. It used an encoding scheme where 8 bits of data are transmitted as a 10-bit symbol. This encoding ensures enough transitions for clock recovery, but introduces a 20% overhead. Gen 2 doubled the speed to 5 gigatransfers per second, maintaining the 8-bit 10-bit encoding. Gen 3, released in 2010, brought a major change with 128-bit 30-bit encoding. This scheme transmit 128 data bits as a 130-bit symbol, reducing the overhead to less than 1.6%. This more efficient encoding, combined with an increase in signaling rate to 8 gigatransfers per second, allowed Gen 3 to achieve nearly double the effective rate of Gen 2. Gen 4 focused on doubling the data rate again to 16 gigatransfers per second while maintaining backwards compatibility. Gen 5 doubled the data rate once more to 32 gigatransfers per second and introduced significant electrical changes, particularly in transmitter and receiver equalization. These equalization improvements were crucial for maintaining signal integrity at such high speeds. As we can see in the eye diagrams, the signal at the receiver pins, the channel output, is severely degraded, with nearly closed eye. However, equalized output shows a much more open eye, demonstrating how effective equalization can recover a clean signal, even from a highly distorted input. The transmitter equalization pre-emphasizes certain frequencies to compensate for expected channel losses, while the receiver equalization further corrects for channel distortions. This two-stage approach allows Gen 5 to achieve reliable communication at 32 gigatransfers per second over PCB traces and connectors that would otherwise be unsuitable for such high frequencies. Gen 6 marks an even more significant shift, moving from NRZ, non-return to zero signaling, to PAM4, pulse amplitude modulation 4 level. NRZ uses two signal levels to represent binary data, PAM4 uses 4 signal levels to encode 2 bits per symbol. This enables Gen 6 to double the data rate to 64 gigatransfers per second without doubling the fundamental frequency, which would have made channel design extremely challenging. However, PAM4 comes with its own challenges. The closer spacing between signal levels makes it more susceptible to noise and requires even more sophisticated equalization techniques. The increasing speeds of each PCIe generation present significant challenges for hardware designers. Signal integrity becomes more critical as data rates rise. Key issues include attenuation. Signals lose strength as they travel along PCB traces. This loss is more pronounced at higher frequencies due to factors such as skin effect and dielectric loss. For PCIe Gen 5 and Gen 6, a signal might lose over half its amplitude over just a few inches of PCB trace. This attenuation can make it difficult for the receiver to distinguish between different signal levels, particularly in PAM4 signaling. Crosstalk. Signals can interfere with each other, particularly in dense multi-lane designs. As PCIe speeds increase, even small amounts of coupling between traces can introduce significant noise. This is especially problematic in multi-lane designs where many high-speed signals run in parallel. Reflections. Impedance mismatches along the signal path can cause reflections, distorting the signal. These mismatches can occur at vias, connectors, or any point where the trace width or layer change occurs. Even small discontinuities can cause significant reflections at higher frequencies, leading to inter-symbol interference. Jitter. Various sources of timing uncertainty can accumulate, making it difficult to recover the signal reliably. This includes random jitter from thermal noise, deterministic jitter from inter-symbol interference, and periodic jitter from power supply noise. As data rates increase, the timing budget becomes tighter, making jitter a critical concern. For PCB designers, these challenges require careful consideration in several areas. Trace design. Traces need to be carefully routed to maintain consistent impedance. This typically involves precisely controlling trace width and spacing. Designers must also minimize length mismatches between lanes in a multi-lane link. Material selection. At high frequencies, the dielectric properties of the PCB material become critical. Designers need to select materials with appropriate loss tangent and dielectric constant. High-speed designs often require more expensive, low-loss materials. Via design. Vias introduce discontinuities and can be a major source of reflections. Careful via design, including techniques like back drilling to remove unused portion of vias, becomes necessary. Power integrity. Clean power delivery is crucial for maintaining signal integrity. This requires careful power distribution network design to minimize power supply noise. EMI considerations. As speeds increase, containing electromagnetic emissions becomes more challenging. This requires careful shielding and layout strategies, potentially including EMI suppression components. Thermal management. Higher data rates often come with increased power consumption, making thermal management an essential consideration in PCB design. Given these challenges, simulation has become integral to the PCB design workflow. In a typical PCIe design workflow, simulation plays a role at multiple stages. Pre-layout exploration. Engineers use simulation to evaluate different topologies and estimate performance early in the design process. This might involve using simplified channel models to assess feasibility quickly. Pre-layout simulation verifies the performance of substrates and allows the calculation of design rules for layout. Post-layout verification. Once the initial PCB layout is complete, more detailed simulations are run using models extracted from the layout. This allows a much more accurate prediction of performance. Optimization. Based on simulation results, designers can iterate on their design, adjusting parameters like trace geometry or equalization settings to improve performance. Compliance checking. Before moving to a physical prototype, simulations can verify whether the design will likely meet PCIe compliance requirements. Historically, setting up these simulations has been a complex and time-consuming process, often taking days or even weeks for a full multi-lane PCIe link. This complexity has been a significant barrier, especially for teams without extensive experience in high-speed serial link simulation. However, recent advancements in simulation tools have dramatically reduced this setup time. With Keysight's new PCIe designer in Pathwave ADS, simulations can be set up in minutes rather than hours or days. This efficiency is crucial, allowing for more design iterations and comprehensive analysis within project timelines. Key types of PCIe simulation include channel simulation. This predicts how the channel will affect signal integrity, including effects like inter-symbol interference. Equalization optimization. Simulation allows engineers to test different equalization settings to compensate for channel losses and optimize signal quality. This is particularly crucial for Gen 5 and Gen 6 designs. Eye diagram analysis. This visually represents signal quality and helps predict bit error rates. Eye diagrams can be generated at various points in the link, helping designers identify where signal quality degrades. Compliance testing. Simulation-based compliance tests, based on the official PCIe specification, allow designers to verify compliance early in the design process. This can save tremendous time and cost compared to relying solely on physical testing. The ability to quickly set up and run these simulations will transform the PCI Express design process, allowing engineers to explore more design options and catch potential issues earlier. As data rate demands grow, PCIe will need to evolve further. Work is already underway on PCIe Gen 7, which aims to double the data rate again to 128 gigatransfers per second per lane. This will likely require even more advanced signaling and equalization techniques. PCIe has come a long way since its introduction, evolving to meet the ever-increasing bandwidth demands of modern computing systems. As we've seen, the shift to higher speeds has brought significant challenges and driven innovations in design and simulation techniques. Thank you for watching, and have a fantastic week.